YouTube, Camodo Gaming here, bringing you guys another episode of Scrap Mechanic. Today, we're going to be checking out the prison. Now, I wrote final in the title of this video because I do feel like this is probably the final build episode. It doesn't mean that we aren't going to go back in here and maybe play, maybe do some challenges. I don't really know what the future holds for the prison, but I do think, as far as building, I'm pretty well done here. So, we're going to do a final tour of the prison, and I'm going to show you guys the couple new little sections that I built and some of the improvements that I've made to the prison. So remember, folks, if you are enjoying Scrap Mechanic, leave this video a thumbs up, helps out my channel, and let's jump right into this. Alright, so we're at the Camodo State Federal Prison. This is an awesome facility. It's about 2 months in the making. Of course, I had my big break from YouTube for about a month there, but I figured this would be one of the first big projects that I wrap up when I come back, so really happy with the facility here. Let's go ahead and start off here at the main road, and then I'll tell you guys what the other roads are. The road on the right side was from the last episode. There was a little riot response team, and that's their entrance over there. And the new entrance is over here on the left side. But for all the new inmates here, the prison bus would pull up. I'll show you guys the bus here in a second. It's actually parked in the new parking lot on the right side. But it would pull up here. It would trip this sensor, and you're ready for your visit to the Camodo State Prison here. So you would ease your way into here. Normally the second gate is closed. There is a little tower up here, a little walkway. So the gate would be closed, the prison would pull into this little box, trip this other sensor here, and those will close in. They'll do a little security check on the bus, make sure nothing illegal is getting in or getting out. So they'll do that, and then they'll allow them to go into the prison. Now, I'm not going to walk up on the walkways. That was from the first episode here. So you've got the walkways, you've got the tower, and you've got the outer fence area with the other towers at the corner. But the actual prison itself is located behind this big wall here. So the bus would pull up, the prison guards would see them over here, and we can go ahead and activate it right here. Oh, I forgot how loud that alarm was. It actually kind of made me jump. So you've got the alarms, you got the lights going off. It's letting everybody know the big main gate is about to open. So it's going to prop open here in a second. Any day now. There we go. So we're going to drive into here, and this is going to be where we drop off our prisoners. So the bus would pull up here. This is the holding cell. I believe this was the second or third episode. This is the episode with the holding cell and the solitary confinement slash psych ward. We'll go over that here in a second. So the bus would pull into here and welcome the new prisoners in. We'll go ahead and close this behind the bus, and we'll put them into the holding cell. This is where they're going to process the prisoners and check them in and get them ready to go into their normal cells. So here's your holding cell right here. This is all controlled from this little back room over here. This room will control the holding cell, the gate over here, and the door to let the prison guards in and out. Let me go ahead and show you guys the spider web real quick. This map is pretty crazy. This is one of the reasons I think it's probably a good time to stop, because I don't want this to become too laggy where you guys can't play with it. By the way, the map download is down in the description, and the vehicles are up in the workshop. But yeah, it's pretty crazy in here. So let's go ahead and close this. So we're ready to transfer the prisoners out. We're going to go ahead and let them go down this kind of long, lonely hallway here. Walk through here. You can see all the cameras. You're going to see these things everywhere in the prison. So don't be surprised if you see them in maybe a couple weird spots in the prison. Alright, so we're ready to go into the next gate here. This is for cell blocks A and B. These are your normal cell blocks. These are for normal prisoners. Nothing wrong with them. This is like I guess you can say it's like a general population. They can go into here. Let's go ahead and run through one of the cell blocks real quick, show you guys it real quick. This was from the first prison episode. I believe this is about where the first prison episode stopped, was these two cell blocks. So you've got these here. Let's go ahead and pop this open. That's the main guard area. He can watch the prisoners. He can actually activate the doors and everything from up in that tower. So yeah, you've got all the cells here. I forgot how many cells are in each of these, but these are actually identical, the A and B cell blocks. So you've got those. You can walk up here. All identical cells here. Really not much to show you here up in this area. I can go ahead and show you how these work. Let's go ahead and hop up onto this. I'm going to hop over this wall here. Hey, the door's already open. So yeah, we can, there's an alarm back here. There's several different, okay, that's the alarm. several different buttons here. That's the lights for the cell block, and I believe this is going to be the doors. The alarm goes off again. I think it's got a little bit of a time delay, and you can see all the doors are open and ready to go. So yeah, we can walk out back this way. This is going to lead to the back area for the guards. You can go around each cell block back here. There's a little fenced off area. We're just going to hop this here. Show you guys how ineffective the fence are for scrap mechanic people. They can just put their lift down and hop over. So let's go over here. So we're not going to go into cell block B because it's the same thing. We're actually heading to one of the new areas here in the prison. This is the yard. This was probably from the third or fourth episode here. You've got your little areas to run. You've got your little areas to sit down. Some weight benches. I didn't put any free weights in here or anything that they can lift and hit each other in the head with. I thought that would be a little inappropriate. But you've got that. You've got your big basketball court here. And you can see the guard tower that watches over this area and the cameras up there. So let's go into the next area. To the left is the cafeteria, and to the right is the shower with the new added laundry room. That's one thing I forgot to add to the prison, and that's something you guys suggested, so we're gonna go over that first. So before we start with the inappropriate shower jokes, it was absolutely amazing watching the comment section last time when I showed this off, and everybody was just making shower jokes, and it was something. But anyways, your showers are all here, and over here is the new little laundry area. So you've got your two washers. Most likely this would be assigned to a prisoner to work in, or maybe a couple actually. This is probably going to be quite a bit of laundry in here. So we've got two big commercial washing units here, and we got two dryer units. You can actually activate these. You got a little light on in there to make it look like it's actually heating up. And of course you got your camera in your face. But this was just a little area that I wanted to add. I wasn't sure if I was going to make this a separate building, but I figured I don't need to do that because realistically it's just going to be a bunch of washers and dryers in there, and that would be kind of boring. So I decided just to make it a little room over here. So happy with the way that came out. Let's go and walk out this way. And let's go ahead and visit the cafeteria. I'm actually really happy with this room here. So get your little metal detector. This would make sure that people can't walk out with dabby items. I don't know, do they get to use actual metal utensils, or do they have to use like plastic? Even plastic utensils might be a little dangerous. So anyways, you would walk into here, line up, grab your trays, grab your cup, come up here, grab your food. You can have workers back here. We do have plenty of jobs in the prison, and one of the new areas is actually a new job area that something you guys suggested that I do, so we'll go over that here, I think, next. So yeah, you've got the little cafeteria, you've got the places to sit down in here, we can walk back into here. This is the kitchen area. I think this was one of the last episodes of the prison that I showed, this little area off in here. So you've got all your big industrial ovens, your heat lamps, you can place all your stuff here. I gave them a grill, but I don't think we get to eat that good, so I don't know how much use this would see. You got that, you got your sinks, you got your little dishwashing area, and you got your walk-in freezer with, you guessed it, there's a camera in here. So anyways, go ahead and close that. There we go. Don't want to let the cool air out. And we'll close this. Okay, so I think it's time to go to the new area. So this is the area that you guys have suggested that I do. A lot of people were suggesting that they wanted a big area for the prisoners to work in. And two things came to mind. One was a farm. Two was like a kind of a factory, maybe to make license plates and stuff like that. And to be honest with you, I'm not really sure how they make money in prisons now these days. So I went with the farm. So let's go ahead and open up this area here. And here we are. This is a completely new section of the prison. And that back there, the actual fenced area and the wall, that is the back of the prison. That's where I've enclosed the whole prison now. So let's go ahead and break down this area. Alright, so this is the farm slash storage area of the prison. Now, I'm pretty sure they're not going to be feeding the prisoners actual fresh produce. Most likely, they're going to go make some money off it. So, you've got your farm areas back here. This is the storage areas where they would load up and haul the produce off and make the prison a little bit of money. But I do see this being good for prisoners. They can go out here, learn a new skill in farming, and get out in the sun and, I guess, somewhat have fun. I don't know how much fun farming is, but I'm pretty sure it's better than sitting in your cell all day. But yeah, this is probably for the good behaved prisoners. We're not going to stick anybody that's been in solitary confinement or maybe the psych ward out here, but everybody else can come out here and have a nice little farming session. Now, I know it does look a little bit odd with some of the plants that I've added in here. Of course, we get some of the normal plants. I've actually kind of dug them down into the ground to make them look like they're planted, even though you can see the little pots in there. Kind of breaks the immersion a little bit, but it's not too bad. So you've got that, you've got some pipe pieces in here, you've got other areas where it looks like they're about to plant some new crops in, so you can only imagine what that might be. I don't know, some of these boxes and stuff are kind of odd to me. I'm kind of curious as to how they're going to use them in survival. But yeah, they're getting ready to go in here and plant some more crops here. You got the big mutant cucumbers here in the back. They're actually kind of scary. You see these in the terrain world where they're out in the fields, and it just looks really, really odd. So yeah, that's a thing. So I've got that. There's the big hose over here. You can take it off. You can water the areas. Now, as far as tools and stuff, that's why I said you have to be well-behaved, because I'm pretty sure some prisoners would try to maybe sneak back with some of the gardening tools. Hopefully that won't be a thing. Now, one thing you're going to notice, we'll go over the tractor here in a second, that the gate, that's the new entrance over here. This would be for the big box trucks to come in and load up the produce and all the goods to take them off. Most likely, the prisoners would not be in the fields when this happens. They probably schedule it around when the prisoners won't be in this area. That's because it doesn't look as max security as the rest of the prison. You've got a couple fences here and some cameras, and there's actually a tower behind the one storage area there, but still probably wouldn't have any trucks drive in while prisoners are actually working. So let's go over this. This is a pretty simple little vehicle here. I normally like to do vehicles in each of my town or builds like this. So this is we'll call this a prison tractor. Now, I'm pretty sure prisoners won't get to drive this, but they will get to load up in this. So this is a little tractor here. It's got a little area for a storage, or actually we got mutant cucumbers back there. You can take them over, and this really saves you probably about, 50 feet maybe from carrying the boxes all over here. I guess ideally we wouldn't have the prisoners walk in this concreted area. They would load up in the tractor and we'll take it off to storage. So let's go ahead and hop up into the tractor here. There we go. You get your lights here in the front. And now with my trailers, I know a lot of you guys know that I attach them to my vehicles. I could make a hitch, but Scrap Mechanic doesn't like that half the time and it lags. So I just go ahead and weld it to the vehicle. And you can just cut it off if you don't like it and just re-weld it when you want the trailer back on. So let's go ahead and drive over here. We're going to hit this ramp. You get a little bit of lag. That's the one thing I'm not too happy with. Those little ramps are on free bearings, and when you hit them, it tends to lag. So yeah, we can pull over here, pull the trailer up, unload. You can see I've already got a couple little stockpile areas over here full of mutant cucumbers, maybe some fresh plants. Maybe one of these will be receiving and one of these will be like outgoing. I'm almost talking in mill terms here. But yeah, you could maybe we're going to receive or ship these mutant corn off and maybe receive some stuff either in here or over on this side. You got another little covered storage area here for the prison. This would also be for the prison to receive maybe new clothes, supplies, all that would be stored back here. And they can be moved into the prison at a later point. So yeah, we've got that. This is the new fenced area. This works kind of like the front gate. This is actually another fence here. Let's go ahead and pop this open. This is the way to get to the guard tower over here and to get to this little catwalk up here. Now, this catwalk's got two different areas. You've got a button here that controls the outside fence, and you've got a side button over here that will control, you guessed it, the inside fence. So it's kind of another one of those situations where you've always got like double layered security everywhere to get in and out of the prison. So I figured this is probably a pretty good little section to have here. So let's go ahead and pop this open here. This one has a little bit of a time delay on it. Actually, this one opens the side one. Oh yeah, the other one opens out here. I forgot about that. I kept thinking that I made it open the outside fence, but the outside fence is actually activated over here, and I've got a bottom switch over on the other side. So the box truck will pull up, kind of confirm himself in the camera here, pop this open, and then they can pull in. So yeah, pretty cool little area over here. Pretty satisfied with the way this came out. Now, I know some people are going to say, where is, and this is the most common request that I didn't do, and it's solely for kind of YouTube reasons, and it's a little dark. A lot of people wanted to see some sort of execution area, and I just wasn't 100% comfortable with doing that in the prison, so I decided to leave that out. That's one thing I know might be a little disappointing to some people, but obviously I left it out for good reason. And plus, YouTube wouldn't really like that. We know how that goes these days with YouTube and any questionable content. It's probably kind of weird that I'm getting away with building a prison in a, I would say it's a kid's game, but it's a game that everybody can enjoy, but it's kind of catered or aimed towards kids, and I know it's a little weird. So, anyways, let's go ahead and continue the little tour here. This is the area that's going to lead you to two areas. You can go to the, this is like the main headquarters, and the riot control armory is all back here, plus the haunted cell block is back in the corner. You can go to this area. Normally, these are all supposed to be closed, so let's go ahead and close that. Or this is one of the big lockups over here. Let's go ahead and close that and show you guys how this fence works, this little gate area. This is the psych ward / solitary confinement. All your bad people, all your crazy people are going to get locked up in here. So walk up here, kind of confirm yourself in the camera, talk over the radio, come in here. Double security, of course, so you have this little walkway you'd get stuck in, and they would activate the main doors. Now, this is the lobby to the solitary confinement. You've got the controllers are back here in this back area, and the person behind the counter here can actually activate the doors. So you would walk into here, get another gate in this section here, and we've got the actual cells here. Let me show you guys how these work. These are actually kind of cool. Oh yeah, I forgot, these have locks on them. Huh. I forgot I even did that. Okay, let's go and go to one that I don't have to reset here. So yeah, this is the solitary confinement cell. You click the first one to actually open it up. You've got the second one here. This could be where you can load in a tray or check in on somebody. And you've got a little section here where you can look in and see what they're doing. For some reason, this one's kind of freaked out. I think I accidentally clicked it and got it stuck. I'll reset that before I put this up for download. So yeah, solitary confinement cell is really basic. No windows. You got your sink, the little crapper, and your bed. It's kind of inappropriate to say crapper, but that's just a common word that we use. So, we've got that. We're almost done with the tour here. We're going to go into the last two sections. This is the prison riot / HQ / armory / basically all the administrative offices and everything are back here. This is all for prison staff. No prisoners should be back here. So, this is the helipad. Let's go ahead and pull out the helicopter here for just a second. This is the police helicopter. This is available on my workshop. I'm not going to let it land because it is a little bit laggy, but it does work. It flies fairly easy. I don't know, nothing really flies too easy in Scrap Mechanic, but I do like the way this flies. This was originally based off a park ranger helicopter that me and Mr. Non-Newtonian created a long time ago. So you got that. Here is the HQ administrative area back here. This is also where the K-9 units are housed. So we can go either side here. Let's go and pop over to the right. You got some offices. This is like a little storage generator area. Actually, I think we got one back there. Yep. You got that. You can walk back into this section here. Here's the K-9 units. You can let them out over here. Kind of looks like a little mini jail cell, even though I didn't mean it to look like that, but you got that. You can always take the K-9 units out back here. This little area they can walk around. You can lock them up into this little back storage here. Let them get some sun. Let them play around a bit. No, it's not a huge area, but you can always take them out in the front yards too. So you've got that. You've got a, like a little HQ area here. This is where they're going to watch all the cameras that are throughout the prison. You've got that. You've got a little rec room area over here. The armory's actually back here. By the way, it seems like I'm speeding through a lot of this. You can always go to the episodes for each of these to get this into more detail, where I kind of break everything down. I'm just kind of speeding through everything at the moment. So yeah, you got a little armory area back here. Let's go and walk over here. This is the main tower. This is the tower where another, kind of like the area down here where they'll watch over the prison. But this is like a physical tower. You got a comms little tower up on top of this. It's like a tower on a tower here. So yeah, you can walk up here. Pretty basic up here. You got your computer monitors. You got all your radios that link out to the radios from the outer towers. and all the radios that are, like, say, inside the towers and the cell blocks, just everywhere, basically. So you got all that. You can even walk outside here if you want to. You can see the new parking lot on that side with all the prison vehicles in it. We'll go over that here in a second. Let's go ahead and walk down here. That's pretty much it for the HQ area. Now, some people are going to ask, well, where does the warden sit? And to me, the warden shouldn't really... I mean, he's kind of got an office in here, but he should be out kind of doing his job, maybe wandering around the prison. I didn't feel like it was necessary to make a dedicated warden's office. So you've got that. Let's go ahead and go back here before we go to the parking lot and check out the haunted section. Now, the haunted section, this was kind of a fun episode. It had a really cool intro to it. By the way, all these will be linked in the description. But yeah, this is the section of the prison they didn't want to break down. This is the original cell block A. It's kind of haunted. They can't really demolish it, so they just built a fence around it. That's the way you do stuff like this. You just build around it if you don't want to go in it. So, as you can see, it's seen better days. All the cell blocks are either rotted out. There's still some furniture in there. You can see that this cell block actually fell through. We can go upstairs here. It's kind of hard to get up these stairs. A couple of them are missing. So you've got that. A lot of the stuff's missing from here. This is actually a little escape area. You can see where they kind of tunneled out, went down the pipes. I don't know. You can kind of make your own backstory up with this prison. So you've got that, and you've got the haunted cell up here. This is kind of a little cool area. There's a sensor there. You pick up that sensor. It actually, let me hit it again. It lights up, and the cell block moves open. That was a part of the intro for this little prison area. Pretty cool, though. Anyways, let's go ahead and walk out here. So, let's go ahead and check out the last little section. This is the employee entrance on this side. Not quite as heavily guarded because you've got fences between you and the prisoners, like, say, the gates there and all the fences. So, I didn't feel the need to do the double gate here. So, you've got that. Let's go ahead and deactivate that. Should close it here in a second. You can see the lights on the top are spinning there and there. So, yeah, this was the other side entrance, and I built a little parking lot out here for the buses, and this is a little prison riot van from the last episode. So, this is also on the workshop if you'd like to check it out. Oh, and it's freaking out. What are you doing? Okay. Yeah, Scrap Mechanic's suspension still hasn't gotten that much better since I've been gone, so still freaks out occasionally. Anyways, got that. You got the prison buses over here to transport the prisons in and out, or prisoners in and out, I should say. But anyways, folks, that's going to about do it for this episode here today. Of course, you saw the new sections, the farm, the storage area, the laundry area, you got the new parking lots. And overall, I've just kind of tidied up the whole prison to where I've gotten it to, I think, to where it runs pretty good. It's still not running the best, but obviously it's quite huge, so you might have some performance issues on it. But anyways, folks, hopefully you enjoyed this episode here today. If you'd like to like and subscribe, everything helps my channel. We will be back with more Scrap Mechanic here very shortly. I've actually got a pretty cool little vehicle coming up. It's kind of a concept vehicle, off-road, futuristic vehicle that I'm hopefully going to show off within the next day or two, as soon as I get more time to work on it. But this is something I wanted to finish for you guys. Now, if you have any suggestions for future builds, future worlds, comment below. I'm still thinking about going back into the town and maybe doing some work in there, so if you have any suggestions for that, let me know. Any vehicle suggestions, whatever you want to suggest, just comment below. I'd like to try to talk to you guys as much as possible. Also, if you have anything you want to send to the channel creations-wise, I still check those out. I will have my email down below and also in the description, so if you'd like to send something over, I'll be sure to check that out for you guys. But anyways, guys, thank you guys for all the love and support over the past kind of month. I know it's been really rocky, but looking to try to get into somewhat of a normal schedule with you guys. So thanks for having me back, and it really does feel good to be back and doing YouTube videos and Scrap Mechanic videos again. So anyways, folks, hopefully you enjoyed this episode, and we will see you guys next time on Scrap Mechanic. Thank you.